When you see around the globe the maldistribution of wealth, the desperate plight of millions of people in underdeveloped countries, when you see so few haves and so many have-nots, when you see the greed and the concentration of power within, did you ever have a moment of doubt about capitalism and whether greed's a good idea to run on?
Well, first of all, tell me, is there some society you know that doesn't run on greed? You think Russia doesn't run on greed? You think China doesn't run on greed? What is greed? Of course, none of us are greedy. It's only the other fellow who's greedy. The world runs on individuals pursuing their separate interests. The great achievements of civilization have not come from government bureaus. Einstein didn't construct his theory under order from a bureaucrat. Henry Ford didn't revolutionize the automobile industry that way. In the only cases in which the masses have escaped from the kind of grinding poverty you're talking about, the only cases in recorded history are where they have had capitalism and largely free trade. If you want to know where the masses are worst off, it's exactly in the kinds of societies that depart from that. So that the record of history is absolutely crystal clear that there is no alternative way so far discovered of improving the lot of the ordinary people that can hold a candle to the productive activities that are unleashed by a free enterprise system.
But it seems to...
Many people think that good is done by caring for others. And my point is, when people ask me, well, what's that human motivation that gets the most wonderful things done? I say greed. I'm not talking about ripping off people, robbing and fraud and stealing. I'm talking about people trying to get as much as they can for themselves. Now, most people don't, you know, they never looked at it away. I say, well, I ask the question. I say, well, look, last winter you had Texas cattle ranchers getting up in the dead of night in blizzards, going out rounding up stray cows, trying to take care of the cows, make sure they're eating, and making this personal sacrifice so that New Yorkers would have beef on their shelves. You have Idaho potato farmers getting up doing backbreaking work, sun beating down and fingernails, dirt underneath their fingernails, bug bites, and making this personal sacrifice so that New Yorkers also have potatoes on the shelves. Now the question is, why are they doing that? Do you think it's because they love New Yorkers? they may hate New Yorkers. I'm not that wild about New Yorkers myself. They may hate New Yorkers, but they make sure that beef and potatoes gets New York every single day of the week. Why? Because they want more for themselves. And that's the great virtue of the free market system, is the way you get more for yourself is by serving your fellow man, making your fellow man happy. And that's what the free market is about. And matter of fact, if you ask the question, the pursuit of profits, in another way is put it, if you ask the question, if you just look around, you look at what do Americans complain about? Well, do we complain about supermarkets? What about our computer stores? Are there a lot of complaints about the clothing stores? No, where do people complain? They complain about public schools, complain about the post office, the motor vehicles department. Compare. Now, cars and television sets and clothing and supermarkets, they're motivated by profits. The public education, the motor vehicle department and post office, they're nonprofit organizations. So profit, profit motivation gets people to try to please their fellow man. Because in a free market, they get more for themselves by serving their fellow man.